In this video, I'm going to do a kinematics problem that has kind of an interesting result. And that interesting result is going to lead us to exploring the next topic. So what I'd like to do is imagine that there's a cannon that is sitting on a cliff, like this, and it's going to fire a projectile with an initial speed v at an angle theta. Okay, and the angle is drawn above the horizontal, but we'll find that it doesn't actually matter. We could draw it below the horizontal and we would get the same result. Okay, so specifically what I would like to do is I would like to know after the projectile lands, and it'll land a distance delta y below the starting point, how fast will it be going? Okay, so I'm not interested in how far it goes or how long it takes. What I really want to know is just that final speed. Okay, so we can solve that. That seems like a pretty ordinary kinematics problem. So to start, we're going to find the initial velocity in the x and y direction. Okay, we know theta, we know v, we can do that. So in the x direction, we're going to have the initial velocity is going to be v times cosine theta. Okay, and meanwhile, in the y direction, the initial velocity is going to be v times sine of theta. Okay, so we split that up into components. In the x direction, this is an ordinary projectile motion problem, so the speed is going to stay constant. In the y direction, we have an acceleration, so the acceleration is going to be equal to negative g, because it's accelerating downward. The delta y, we're given as delta y. Okay, so we know what that's going to be. And then that's three of the five quantities, so we can solve. The one that we actually wanted was the final y velocity. So what I'm going to do is use vfy squared equals vi y squared plus 2a delta y. Okay, so what I want to do is plug in for the initial velocity, v sine theta, which is squared, and then minus 2g delta y. Okay, so that is my final y velocity squared. Okay, the final x velocity squared is just going to be v squared cosine squared theta. Okay, so if I want to find the final velocity, that's going to be the square root of the final x velocity squared plus the final y velocity squared. Okay, and I have quantities for both of those. So square root of v squared cosine squared theta, that was my vx. My vy squared is going to be v squared sine squared theta minus 2g delta y. Okay. And what I notice is that I have two terms under the square root, v squared cosine squared theta and v squared sine squared theta. So depending on how recently you've taken trigonometry, you might recognize cosine squared plus sine squared as being just a way of writing one. And so we can simplify this to just v squared minus 2g delta y. Okay, and this is the result. And the thing that I want you to notice is that theta does not appear in this result. Okay, the angle doesn't matter. Okay, which is really pretty surprising. Ordinarily, in a kinematics problem, you'd have to worry about everything. You have to worry about splitting stuff into components, you have to worry about accelerations and times and stuff. But for this particular quantity, if we want to know the final speed with which the cannonball lands, that does not depend on the angle that we fire the cannonball at. So if we fire it horizontally, or mostly upwards, or mostly downwards, we get the exact same speed. So ordinarily, when you notice something like this, a result that doesn't depend on something that seems like it should depend on, usually we expect that there's a reason for it. And in fact, we'll see that there is a reason for it, and the reason has to do with energy, which is the topic of this chapter.